folks. Welcome to the winter edition of Tiny Tent Show. This program is designed to keep us warm in our memories of last summer's amazing concerts and to stoke the fires of anticipation for the next time that we gather up together under canvas. In tonight's show, we address that age-old question, can there really be that much talent crammed into one little patch of woods? The answer, of course, as you know by now, is yes. And tonight we'll feature projects that involve two of our Blue Canvas Orchestra members, Nori Schwenzfeier and Molly Otis. We will also revisit a song from Big Top's flagship show, Riding the Wind. Molly Otis is a singer-songwriter vested with the power to move us deeply. A Molly O performance can have us up on our feet and dancing to her rock and bluegrass infused sound. It can also draw us deep inside our own souls with Molly's unguarded honesty. We at the Big Top feel so very fortunate that she returned to the south shore of Lake Superior where she lives, just a few miles from the tent. Tom is a Blue Canvas Orchestra member himself and one of the principal players in the Big Top Summer Bluegrass Camp for Kids.
Rand? Well, like I was saying, we got a band of songwriters, and one of the finest of us is Molly Otis here. She's going to sing a song that's so new, it's got that new car smell.
It's very new. I just wrote this song, and it's called Witness Tree. And a witness tree is an actual surveyor's mark. When a surveyor comes to a corner and there's a tree in its place where they can't put a monument of any kind, they call it a witness tree. And I've always loved that term and decided to write a song, but this is not about surveying. It's about forgiving yourself. I fell down on my knee in front of the witness tree. I never talk about it. You'd never know. But there's a shame that eats my soul. It hangs on me like an ill-fitting dress. It's my companion until I confess. to the witness tree, the witness tree, follow me. Bend down on your knees in front of the witness tree. It's all right,
riding around in the breeze. Well, it's all right, if you live the life you please. Well, it's all right, doing the best you can. Well, it's all right, as long as you lend a hand. You can sit around and wait for the phone to ring.
End of the line,
waiting for someone to tell you everything.
At the end of the line,
sit around and wonder what tomorrow will bring.
At the end of the line,
maybe a diamond ring.
But it's all right, even if you're singing it wrong. Yes, it's all right. Yes, yeah, sometimes you got to be strong, but it's all.
Now we turn our summer spotlight to a warm evening from our canvas past. This one from the show that built the tent, Riding the Wind.
Thank you. These islands were called the Apostles by early Jesuits. A Voyager tale tells they were named for the 12 apostles, 7 devils, and 2 sisters. They have had many names.
Madeline Island is Manawana Conning Menis, Island of the Golden-Breasted Woodpecker.
The French named it Île des Tours, La Ronde, Montreal, Saint-Michel, La Pointe, Mandolin, Saint-Esprit.
The English called it Cadat, Woodpecker, Middle, Michael.
Explorer scientist Henry Schoolcraft named it Virginia after the state and named the entire apostle group the Federation Islands.
Stockton Island is still known by the old French, Presque Isle. Lake Superior was La Tracie. Shawamigan Bay was first La Baie de Saint-Esprit, or Bay of the Holy Ghost. Shawamigan is the French sounding for the Ojibwa Shagawamakong's Soft Beaver Dam.
Ago, when Winnebajou was familiar with this part of the country, his favorite place was Lake Superior. And in his travels around this bay, he noticed that a giant beaver made its home here. So Winnebajou decided to capture this great beaver, and he decided to build a dam across the bay. He used rock, sticks, and sand, and he built his dam across the bay. Long Island, they say, still exists as part of that dam that Winnebajou built. But poor Winnebajou was disappointed because he didn't build his dam strong enough. And the giant beaver escaped and swallowed into the lake. Winnebajou was so angry that he took handfuls of this dam and he threw it at the beaver as he swam away. As far as he could see, Winnebajou kept throwing handfuls of the dam. And that is how these islands were formed. So now you know them by another name, Winnebajou Islands. Not all these other names that they were giving you. Hey, it's good to be back.
In 1871, there were 341 steamboat arrivals at the Bayfield docks. Let's get down to the dock to see what's about, see who's coming in and who's going out.
On September 25th, 1897, the popular whaleback Christopher Columbus landed at the Dalrymple dock with 8,000 excursionists on board.
What a big fuss the day the president came. August 22nd, 1928, Calvin and Mrs. Coolidge boarded the Woods yacht, the Nellwood, at the city dock for a picnic on Devil's Island.
Floating
best and your best steamer take you away? Are you traveling on the Asia or the good man stay? The peerless is due in from Sault Ste. Marie. Those grand, regal, portly, proud, magnificent boats, so splendid in Columbus, those palaces float. Boarding by day or by the light of the moon, soon you'll be strolling the royal saloon at Woodstock, waiting for the Indian, at Vonstock, waiting for the Iroquois. Ahoy there, a packet liner bringing mail, a schooner with all the wind she wants at full sail. The Mackinac's a tempting and lying ashore. Out to the nets go the fish bones once more.
Riding the wind, under my skin, I feel the
big white people take me to the islands, out around the Apostle Island. All right, we're going sailing. You put your name, you put your address, so they can let you know when the meetings are. And then on the bottom it says, if I owned a boat, I'd call it. Take me to the island, out around the possible island.
You're about to enjoy the music of a band called Tin Can Gin, and I would say that they have a bluegrassy sound, and I say grassy just because each member of this band brings their own inflection, their own style to the sound. And we are, of course, here especially proud of one of the members of Tin Can Gin, Nori Schwenzfeier, because she is a regular member of the Blue Canvas Orchestra. So it's terrific to watch her performing in another element here with the band Tin Can Gin.
to Minnesota, jumping on the tracks, trying to see the world, nothing's on the back. Fly to everyone's sweet, to a banjo on her knee, watch her go as she flees. Oh, Caroline, why must she run? She says it's just for fun. They go down to New Orleans, trying to chase the sun, stuck in that and have a little fun. Dancing when the music plays, she wishes she could stay. Watch her go her own way. Oh, Caroline, why must she run? She says it's just for fun. Say goodbye to the past. I'd miss you, my Caroline. You run so fast. If you see my Caroline, would you send her my way? I hope to see her someday. Oh, Caroline, why must she run? She says it's just for fun. Thank you.
Excitement gets the best of me sometimes. But we all doing good? All right.
Hey, cheers to 35 years of this beautiful place, huh? Truly an honor to be up here playing music for you.
Toward the wind, but some nights I'll dream about you beneath the open sky, and I'll
I'll miss you close beside me and the hazel in your eyes. So let it reel, let it rock, let it rectify your soul. Let our bones keep dancing round till our bodies all turn cold. And when our run is through, I know where I'll reside with the ladies and gents on the OS side. So let it reel, let it rock, let it rectify your soul. Let our bones keep dancing round till our bodies all turn cold. And when our run is through, I know where I'll reside with the ladies and gents on the OS side. OS side. OS
That tune was written by a great band out of the state of Ohio. They're called the Tillers. We're gonna sing you a song about coming back home to Duluth.
you folks. To spend time alone. The only car I see is red. I'll give you the fuel and grab some gin. And some of the time for some gin will never stop. Never stop. I'm at the point, there's nothing to grasp. Another round is gone too fast. Falling down in a gravel pit. For the past 5 nights I've been drinking devil's spit. Take my booze and mix with gin. The only car I see is red. I'll give you the feeling that we're some gin. And some other time, some gin will never stop. Never stop. I'm at the point, there's nothing to grasp. Another round is done too fast. Falling down in a gravel pit. For the past 5 nights, I've been drinking devil spit.
Over there on that bass. Double dipping tonight. Thank you. Give it up for Trevor's hair on that last one. Thanks so much. Give it up for Neil on that bass. Mr. Neil Krause. Bryan Nelson on the mandolin. Trevor Marrin on the guitar. Nori on the fiddle.
And Harrison Oak on the banjo.
Thanks for joining the show, folks. Please return again next week when we'll be featuring the new Big Top original production, Dear Earth. A love song letter of hope. We'll also have a performance by Martha Redbone. As always, we thank our sponsors, Jim and Joy Perry, Roger and Sharon Shaver, Dick and Sandy Olson, Patrick and Mary Lou Irvin, Myra Aynert. Thank you, sponsors. And with that, I say, not goodbye, but instead what they always say where I'm from, which is, well, I suppose.
Can't reach, oh, please. catch my rider.